Well, hey, it's Rob, and I woke up at 4 in the morning here just thinking about this story. Thought I would share it with you. It's a cute little story about the time I worked with Michael Jackson. Well, I wouldn't say I worked with him. I worked in the same building where he was recording Dangerous. My job was a very important one. I picked up lunch every day and cleaned up the studio at night, and really just kind of those mundane tasks you do when you are just starting out in your career. But nevertheless, I happen to be starting out at the studio where Michael was recording Dangerous. So this studio was called, and still is, Record One. It's in Sherman Oaks in Los Angeles on Ventura Boulevard. I believe Dr. Dre is or was for many years kind of the person who was working there. I don't think he owns it, but I'm not sure anymore. It's been a long time. In any case, back then, for 2 years, Michael had a lockout on the studio, which meant he was the only person recording there. There were two actual recording studios in the building, another little room where someone else was working on editing and that kind of stuff. So he spent, I believe, I heard the figure was $5,000, and that was every day that he recorded at the studio. It sounds like a lot of money, but he had the run of the place. He had a secure parking lot. He had a special private room in the back. We had a kitchen and a living room. It was more like a house that had, you know, two recording studios in it. Of course, two world-class, you know, high-quality recording studios with the best equipment and everything you need to make a major record release like Dangerous. Anyway, so to get to what I wanted to talk about today, I was the guy who kind of mostly sat at the reception desk up front. We answered phones, even though we had an actual receptionist most of the time. And like I said, I wasn't doing anything all that important in the scheme of things, but I was there every day. And one of the days, Michael was in, he left, I was cleaning up, and I found this note right here on my desk. I often think about this note when I think about Michael, and I think, just what a nice guy he was, what a considerate guy. He's Michael Jackson. Why does he care what anyone thinks of him? Why is he worried that some guy who makes, you know, $5.15 an hour, which I think is what I got paid by back then, why does he care what I or anybody else, you know, working around me, you know, thinks about him? And why is he worried that he's going to offend someone, you know, by stealing a pen? Can you imagine Michael Jackson, all the money, fame, and everything, and what's running through his mind? You know, and I try to imitate him because this is kind of how he sounded. And he used to call me Robbie. He said, Robbie, are you going to go to the war? He'd say these oddball things sometimes to me. But, you know, I think about him saying, you know, oh boy, you know, I hope they're not mad at me for taking an ink pin. He wrote down pin, but like we were going to go through the cup where the pens were held and say, wait a minute, there used to be 15, now there's only 14. That Michael Jackson, he took our pen. You know, it's just crazy that with all the other things and pressures and things that he had to think about during his day, that his big concern at that moment at least was, you know, gee, I hope they don't get mad at me because I took one of their pens.